I am going to continue the chapter as you like it. Already I did the chapter, the first half of the story, that there were two dukes, Duke Senior and Duke Frederick. Duke Frederick deposed Duke Senior and he took shelter in the forest of Arden. There he spent a lazy life free from any kind of tension, worries or cares of court. And Duke Frederick on the other hand also banished Rosalind, and Rosalind also went to the forest of Arden. Before that, Rosalind and Celia attended one wrestling match between Oliver and the royal wrestler Charles, in which Oliver the young man defeated the royal wrestler Charles. And when Duke Frederick came to know about the Orlando, that Orlando was the son of the Sir Roland de Bois, the friend of Duke Senior, he became angry, and he also came to know that Rosalind was appreciated by the other lords and other people of the court, and they pitied him for her condition. When he heard these stories, he just banished Rosalind also from the court. And Rosalind and Celia, both inseparable companions, they just went away to the forest of Arden. And Rosalind went in the forest of Arden in search of her father. There, at first, they could not get any shelter, food or rest. But later on, they bought a house of the shepherd and they settled down there. And one main thing which has to be pointed out, that they left the palace in the disguise. Rosalind was disguised as a country lad named Ganymede, and Celia was disguised as a country lass named Eliana. So now I am continuing the story. The two sisters settled in their new cottage life very comfortably and fancied themselves to be the shepherd and shepherdess. Yet sometimes Ganymede remembered the youth Orlando and thought that he was so far away from her. But it soon came to light that he was also in the forest of Arden following certain circumstances. So the two sisters settled down as the shepherd and the shepherdess. They were spending a nice time there, and at that time, sometimes Ganymede, who was originally Rosalind, used to remember whom? Orlando. And by chance, they came to know that Orlando also had entered the forest of Arden. Orlando was the younger son of Sir Roland de Bois. When many died, he placed Orlando in the custody of his older son, requesting him to bring him up his brother and with proper care. Oliver, the elder brother, however, did not keep the request of his father and likewise did not educate Orlando in school. Orlando, even without a care and help of his brother, grew up to be a fine man, and Oliver hated him more than that. Now, Orlando was the younger son of Sir Roland de Bois. Sir Roland de Bois had another elder son whose name was Oliver. And Oliver taking care of Orlando after Sir Roland de Bois' death, as he promised Sir Roland de Bois that he would take care of Orlando, his younger brother. And when Sir Roland de Bois died, Orlando was kept under the guidance of Oliver, so that he could take proper care of his younger brother. And he had also made promise to the Sir Roland de Bois that he would send Oliver to school and he would be given proper education and proper care. But Oliver did not pay any attention to such things which he had promised. Ultimately, what happened? Oliver neglected his duties, but Orlando grew up to be a fine gentleman. Though Orlando was not sent to school or given proper education, Orlando grew up to be a fine young gentleman. He was the one who had arranged for the fight, as he wanted to get rid of his younger brother, but the fate would have it, Orlando won the wrestling match. Nevertheless, he was sad at the disposition of his brother, and being friendless, he wished not to leave. Now, Oliver planned the wrestling fight. Why? Because he wanted to get rid of his brother. Now, ultimately, what happened? Orlando defeated Charles. And when Orlando defeated Charles, what happened? Oliver became sad. And on the other hand, Orlando was also very depressed when he came to know about his brother's nature. And he thought that he was friendless and he should not live on this earth. When Oliver heard of the victory news of his younger brother Orlando, his jealousy knew no bounds. He vowed to burn his brother alive in his chamber while he slept. This was overheard by one of the old servants of Sir Rolandi, and he at once set out to warn Orlando of his impending danger. Now what happened? When Oliver heard the victory news of his younger brother, and he became jealous. And at that time he thought about that he would put an end to his brother, and he thought that he would burn him alive in his chamber when he would be sleeping. This plan was overheard by whom? By one of the most faithful servants of Sir Orlando Boyce, whose name was Adam. And he at once warned whom? Orlando, of his impending danger, or the danger which was about to come. He had a special affection for Orlando, as he much resembled his father. Hence, as soon as he saw Orlando, he broke into passionate exclamations. "Oh, my gentle master, oh, my sweet master, oh, you memory of Sir Orlando. Why are you so virtuous? Why are you so gentle, strong, and valiant? And why would you be so fond to overcome the famous wrestler? Your praises come too swiftly home before you." Orlando could not comprehend what the matter was. The servant explained to him the reason of his concern, stating his plan of his brother to burn him in his own chamber. Now what happened? Orlando, this old servant Adam, he was very fond of Orlando. As soon as he saw Orlando, he broke into passionate exclamations. Means he was eagerly expressing his feelings. That, "Sir, why are you so virtuous? Why are you so strong and valiant? And why you are gentle? And why this set of virtuous qualities were there in Orlando?" And he also informed that he had won the wrestling match. The news of his victory had reached home earlier than him. As a result, Oliver had become jealous, and he was then ready to burn him alive in his chamber. Adam, as the servant was named, advised Orlando to flee the place. And he knowing very well that Orlando had no money, brought him whatever money he had saved for future use, saying that he gave the gold amounting to 500 crowns to Orlando and requested Orlando to allow him to be his servant, and promised that though he looked old, he would take good care of Orlando and work for him. Now, at that time, Adam suggested that they should leave the house forever and they should go somewhere else. They should escape from the place. After telling this, Adam also gave his life savings of 500 crowns to Orlando. And also he requested Orlando to engage him as his servant. And he said that though he had become old, but he would take good care of Orlando. Now Orlando had worked for him, and he would work for him. Orlando was pleased and grateful at the faithfulness of Madam and of Adam, whom he addressed as good old man. And at once they set out with the promise that they would find some work before they had spent the savings that Adam had given him. So Orlando and Adam were ready to leave the place of Oliver, and they wanted to escape from there. And the virtuous qualities of Adam attracted Orlando, and he started stating Adam as a very good old man. And once they set out with the promise, Orlando was ready to set out, and he made a promise that once they would settle and before spending all money which Adam had given him, he would definitely find some work. The servant traveled long till they reached the forest of Arden, and they were also as tired and hungry as the two sisters had. They tried in vain to find a shelter and food at last. When Adam could go no further, Orlando carried him in his arms to the shelter of a tree and cheered him, saying, "Good old man, rest your weary limbs here a while and do not talk of dying." Now, they both went to the forest of Arden, but they could not find any suitable shelter for them. And they were very tired. They were also very hungry, like the two sisters, Rosaline and Celia. And they just searched in vain, means no efforts were fruitful. They searched in vain for shelter and food, but at a certain point of time, as Adam was old, he could not go any further. And he became very tired. Orlando carried him in his arms, and he was cheering constantly to Adam and said that good old man, you are just tired, you just rest a while, then you please do not talk of dying. Orlando then searched for food and by chance came upon the company of the Duke and his friends. When Orlando reached there, it was dinner time. The Duke had sat down for dinner. Orlando, finding food, drew his sword to grab the food from the Duke and his men. Now Orlando was searching for food for Adam. Now at that time, when he was searching for food for Adam, he came to the Duke, and the Duke and his followers were ready to take dinner. And what happened when Orlando saw them? There was dinner time, and the Duke and his followers sat down for dinner. Orlando, finding food, drew his sword to grab the food from the Duke and his men. And Orlando, he had now other option. He wanted to take the food, so he became very ruthless, and he just took out his sword and he threatened the Duke to give him food. He charged them not to touch a morsel. Then the Duke was kind and asked him the reason for his rude behavior. He wanted to know if it was due to hunger or did he despise the cuts he known to Sybil. Now he ordered all the members of the Duke's group and his faithful followers and the Duke himself that he should not take food until he would allow them to take food. But the Duke could understand that why he was so desperate and why he was so recklessly asking for food, and he wanted to know. He became very polite to Orlando, and he wanted to know if Orlando was extremely hungry, that's why he was demanding food in that way. So Orlando then the Duke asked that why he was putting such rude behavior in front of him for food. And that time Orlando then spoke of Adam and declared that though he was hungry, he would not touch food unless Adam was fed. The Duke told him to bring his friend and said that they would wait for him for them. So the Duke spoke to him kindly and asked for dinner. Orlando then spoke to Adam and declared that he was hungry as well as his friend was hungry, but he would not take any fruit without Adam. So the Duke ordered Orlando to bring the old man quickly, and the Duke was ready to share his free food with them. So and the Duke told him to bring his friend and said that they would wait for them. Orlando went quickly, brought the old man, and then brought them along with the Duke and food and their satisfaction. So the Duke had food and their satisfaction. All of them were fed properly, and the Duke was happy to feed Orlando and Adam. After the dinner, the Duke asked Orlando about him, and when he came to know that Orlando was his friend's son, he took Orlando and Adam under his care. So after dinner, the Duke asked about Orlando's identity. When it was discussed that Orlando was the son of Sir Rowland de Bois, so the Duke took Orlando under his care, as well as Adam was also there with him.